Now, over the years, the Beyblade Burst franchise has had 5 different series, spanning from Single Layers to Dual Layers, Chozy, GT, and finally the brand new Sparking series. Today, I'm going to talk about the best stock combo Beyblade from each Beyblade generation. Now, a stock combo means the combo that the Beyblade gets out of the box. So, for instance, a Beyblade might have a really good layer out of the box, like the layer might be the best layer in the game, but the parts on that layer are horrible. That Beyblade's probably not going to make it on this list. I just want to say that. And also another disclaimer, this is my own opinion. This video is kind of subjective. This is what I believe to be the best Beyblade in each generation or each series. If you don't agree with the list, tell me what Beyblades you think should be on the list in the comment section below. All right, now that we got that out of the way, let's get started with the single layers. Now, there isn't really one single layer stock combo, at least what I believe, that dominated the whole entire meta. Most of the single layers were somewhat equal. I feel like the worst single layer could probably beat the best single layer, so this was kind of hard to choose. But what I believe to be the best single layer stock combo has to be Neptune Arm Zephyr. First off, the Neptune layer was just extremely round, which gave the Beyblade well-needed stamina and defense. It also had really good teeth, giving the Beyblade really good burst resistance. And when you combine that with the arm disc, which also gives the Beyblade really good burst resistance, and the Zephyr driver, and the Zephyr driver wasn't anything crazy. If you guys don't know what the Zephyr driver is, it's basically the Excel driver. It's a plastic flat, except it has a hole in it. In theory, that's supposed to give Zephyr more stamina and less attack power, but in actuality, it's the same thing as Excel. Now, Neptune as a whole is a very good Beyblade. Again, it has decent defense because of the layer. Arm gives the Beyblade decent burst resistance, and the Zephyr driver is aggressive enough to get solid attack type hits, but not too aggressive where it loses a lot of stamina. So it's very good at tornado stalling. I think it's overall the most well-balanced single layer Beyblades. Now, there are some other single layers that I was considering putting in this spot, such as Death Scyther. Death Scyther had a really round design, just like Neptune, and really good teeth. The problem with Death Scyther is that it came with the oval disc, which is like the lightest, worst disc at the time. Another Beyblade I wanted to put on was Odin, and Odin, the layer itself is amazing. The Odin layer dominated the meta when it first came out, but the stock combo on Odin is just really bad. It comes with Centro, which is okay, and the Blow driver, which, for lack of better words, it blows. It has horrible stability, so if you hit Odin over, it'll just like fall over, and the Blow driver doesn't have much attack power for an attack type Beyblade like Odin, although Odin isn't really suited for attack. It's more of a stamina defense type layer, which is really weird. Anyway, so what I think to be the best single layer Beyblade overall definitely has to be Neptune Arm Zephyr. Moving on to dual layers, and just like single layers, there was not one Beyblade that dominated the whole meta, at least not one stock combo Beyblade. There definitely was one Beyblade that dominated the whole meta back in the dual layer days. Cough, cough, Dark Death Scyther, that Beyblade was insane. Anyway, what I believe to be the best dual layer stock combo Beyblade has to be Lost Longinus. Now, the parts that come on Lost Longinus aren't that impressive. First off, we have the 9 disc, and I guess the 9 disc is kind of impressive because it's very pretty, because it comes in a nice like metallic blue color, but competitively it's kind of just like an average disc. And next we have the Spiral driver, and the Spiral driver, it's a fairly good attack type driver. You can get some solid attack type hits, but it's definitely hard to control, so it's not the best attack type driver out there. What really makes Longinus shine is its uniqueness compared to all of the other dual layer Beyblades. Before Longinus, there was no other left spin Beyblade. Longinus is the only left spin dual layer Beyblade, which is crazy. And it's also the only dual layer Beyblade that has metal incorporated onto the layer, if you don't count like screws and maybe like Zeus's little metal balls that really don't do anything. So because Longinus was the only left spin Beyblade, it didn't give Longinus many counters. Do you guys know the slow burst that Free does in the anime, where he like slowly launches his left spin Beyblade, and if a right spin Beyblade comes at it at a really fast speed, it'll burst instantly? Yeah, that works the same for Longinus as well. And I remember using that with Lost Longinus back in the day, and it was killer. It destroyed any tiny Beyblade, and it was to the point where like your opponent would have to like weak launch their Beyblade in order to not burst. Longinus was just insane like that. So yeah, I definitely think Lost Longinus was the best stock combo dual layer Beyblade. Some runner-ups I want to talk about. Dark Death Scyther, amazing layer, really round, gave it really good stamina, and it had really good burst resistance. It had the Force Disc and the Jaggy Driver, which were fairly good at tornado stalling. I almost picked this guy, but it also has some problems with balancing. It gets off balance very easily. It's disabled very easily, so I didn't really want to put it on the list. Another Beyblade I thought was really good, but just didn't quite make the list, is Acid Anubis. Acid Anubis is a killer Beyblade. Like, it's super round, giving the Beyblade really good stamina. It has the Yell Disc, which provides some much needed burst resistance because of all the holes in the Yell Disc. And then finally, it came with the Orbit Driver, the best defense driver in the game. The reason I picked Longinus over Acid Anubis was just because, well, I thought Longinus was more unique, and I thought Longinus was slightly better. All right, moving on to the next series of Beyblades, we are on to the God series of Beyblades. And unlike the single layer and the dual layer series, there is one stock combo that definitely stood out compared to the rest. And do I even need to say it? It's flipping Spriggan Requiem. Takeratomi totally broke the game when they released Spriggan Requiem, the main antagonist of the God series. Okay, I want to talk about the layer first, but there's just so much to the layer that we're just gonna skip to the other parts. First off, we have the disc, and the disc is Zero. Now, at the time, Zero was the heaviest disc to be released. That's all I have to say about Zero. Next, we're on to Zeta. And Zeta, although not the best driver in the game, it's very versatile. It has a mode change where you can switch between three modes. You have an attack type mode, which is like a quake driver. You have a defense type mode, which is kind of like a ball driver, somewhat like massive. And then finally, you have a stamina type mode, which isn't really a stamina type mode. It's a balance mode. It's the fusion driver, but they call it a stamina mode for some reason I really don't understand. Anyway, so yeah, although Zeta is not the best driver in the world, it's definitely versatile, and when you combine that with the layer, this Beyblade is just extremely OP. Let's talk about the layer now. So there's just so much to say about the Spriggan Requiem layer. Not only does it have rubber like Fafnir, not only does it have a metal god chip like Legend Spriggan, not only does it have an amazing round design that gives the Beyblade really good stamina in defense, but it is also dual spin. And the crazy thing about giving Spriggan Requiem dual spin is you're probably thinking like, oh, dual spin, whatever. Legend Spriggan before it had dual spin. No, this Beyblade's completely different from Legend Spriggan because this thing is so much more round and it has rubber, and that gives it the capability to steal spin from other Beyblades. And when you're dual spin and you can spin steal from other Beyblades, you can spin steal from left and right spin Beyblades. That's the problem with Fafnir. Fafnir can only steal spin from right spin Beyblades. But because Spriggan is dual spin, it can spin steal from both left and right spin Beyblades. Match that with the Zeta driver, which has a ball mode, and the ball mode has decent life after death. If you're versing Spriggan Requiem and you don't have a driver with better life after death than Zeta, you basically lose. And to put in perspective, that's like every Beyblade that doesn't have a free spin driver. If you have a sharp tip, if you have a flat tip, if you have a rubber tip, you're going to lose to Zeta at life after death because Zeta has a ball tip. And if your opponent has a ball tip, it's probably gonna be in a stall out. It's gonna be an even chance. But yeah, Spriggan Requiem basically beats more than half the cast just because it's able to steal spin. And if you can't beat your opponent at life after death, then you would never steal spin from them, so you just go the same spin direction as them and beat them using like your attack mode or your stamina mode. This Beyblade was just completely broken, and not only that, again, it came with Zero, the heaviest disc in the game. Overall, Spriggan was just a completely broken Beyblade that actually managed to get banned from WBO tournaments for a time. It was just that dominant. Okay, that was crazy. Enough talking about Spriggan and the God series. Let's move on to the Chozy series. What Beyblade do I think is the best in the Chozy series, at least stock combo-wise? Is it going to be another Spriggan? Sadly, I don't think Chozy Spriggan is the best Beyblade in the Chozy series. I actually think that Archer Hercules is by far the best Beyblade in the Chozy series. And unlike Spriggan Requiem, which was kind of like a jack-of-all-trades, it did so many things, it had so many gimmicks, Archer Hercules just does one thing so well that it just dominated the stock combo meta. It was so good that whenever me and Jake did draft battles back in the day, whoever went first basically won, because they chose Archer Hercules and it sweeped everyone. This Beyblade was just that good. Now, the reason why this Beyblade was so good was because of its incredible stamina. If you look at the Archer Hercules layer, as you know, most Chozzy Beyblades, actually all Chozzy Beyblades, have metal infused into the layer. That's kind of the gimmick. The metal on Archer Hercules' layer is towards the outside of the Beyblade, and because most all the weight is on the outside of the Beyblade, that gives the Beyblade a lot of rotational inertia, giving it extreme stamina. And not only does it give it extreme stamina, it also gives the Beyblade quite a lot of defense. When you combine that with the new Eternal driver that released with Archer Hercules, which was basically a better revolve driver, it was a lower, smaller revolve driver with palm plastic, this Beyblade was just so dominant. Now, the 13 disc wasn't amazing, but for some reason, it just worked really well with Archer Hercules. Here's another story of just how good Archer Hercules was. Do you guys remember the Beytuber Brawl, the giant tournament where all the Beytubers met up? It was one of the biggest Beyblade tournaments ever. Yeah, do you guys know JoJo? Not JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, but the Beyblade YouTuber. She actually hosts a bunch of WBO events back in LA, and she's super into the Beyblade competitive scene. She was using an extremely competitive combo. I think it was like Hell Salamander, Zero Bump Atomic, against someone just using a stock Archer Hercules that they bought the same day, and she lost to Archer Hercules at Life After Death with Atomic compared to Archer Hercules with just Eternal. This Beyblade was just that good. It had extreme stamina and it had extreme life after death. Nothing was stopping this. Now, there were some Beyblades that could sometimes beat it. If I remember correctly, Revive Phoenix could sometimes beat it, sometimes Chozzy Valkyrie, but for the most part, Archer Hercules just dominated every single stock combo Chozzy Beyblade, and even competitive combos. This Beyblade was on a roll. It was crazy. Okay, next, let's move on to the best GT stock combo Beyblade. The best GT stock combo Beyblade, we're going full circle back to Spriggan. The best GT stock combo Beyblade definitely has to be Lord Spriggan. Again, do I even need to explain? It's like the same thing as Spriggan Rec Room. We're gonna skip the layer for now, because the layer is what makes Spriggan amazing. Let's talk about the other parts. First off, it comes with the Blitz Disc, which just like the Zero Disc that released with Spriggan, the Blitz Disc was one of the heaviest, if not the heaviest disc to be out when Spriggan was released. So it was an extremely heavy disc, enough said. Moving on to the driver, the Dimension Dash driver gave the Beyblade a lot of burst resistance because it was a dash driver, and it was also extremely versatile because you could change the driver mode. They actually advertised the Dimension driver as having like infinite modes or something, so that definitely helped Spriggan. But the main thing that makes Spriggan so good is the layer. And to put in perspective, I'm not going to explain all of Spriggan's gimmicks again, because I already did that with Spriggan Rec Room. But imagine Spriggan Rec Room, which was so dominant that the WBO had to ban it. Takara Tomy looked at this Beyblade and they're like, we can make that better. They gave the Beyblade even more rubber. And not only that, they looked at the Beyblade and they definitely did not have to do this. No one was expecting them to do this. They freaking gave the Beyblade burst resistors, which makes the Beyblade like never burst. It is crazy. I don't understand how Takara Tomy looked at Spriggan and was like, yeah, I mean, this Beyblade's good, but why not make it better? Like, they had no reason to give the Beyblade burst resistors. Like, I don't know why they did it. It was already such a broken Beyblade, but then they were like, yeah, let's just make it even more broken and totally break the metagame. It makes no sense to me. Takara Tomy was just crazy. They couldn't, it wasn't enough for Spriggan to just have rubber, to just have metal, to just be dual spin. They had to give it flipping burst resistors. And is it because Chozzy Spriggan had like burst stoppers that they were like, oh, when we make the new Spriggan, it has to be better than the other Spriggan, so let's give it burst resistors? If that's the case, then why didn't Slash Valkyrie have burst resistors? Because Chozzy Valkyrie had burst resistors. It just doesn't make sense, and I'm so confused. I don't know why they made the Beyblade so broken. Like, I'm not complaining, because Spriggan is my favorite Beyblade, but Takara Tomy had to know what they were doing at the time, because they gave the Beyblade literally everything. Anyway, I don't even need to explain any more about why Lord Spriggan is so OP. Again, it's basically the same thing as Spriggan Requiem, except just better. Enough venting about Spriggans. I know, I get kind of crazy when I talk about Spriggans. I'm sorry about that, I apologize. Let's move on to the final season, Beyblade Burst Sparking. Now, of course, not all the Sparking Beyblades have been released. For now, we only have, what, like 6 Sparking Beyblades? But out of the 6, the Sparking Beyblade that I believe is the best definitely has to be Super Hyperion. Now, Super Hyperion, unlike the Spriggans we talked about before, it's definitely similar to Archer Hercules, where it just does one thing really well. And that one thing is, it's an extremely good attack-type Beyblade. It has a very ovular shape, which makes it just hit like a wall. Like, it gets such hard hits, it's super powerful. And then it also has a double chassis, which provides the Beyblade with weight, and it also gives the Beyblade much needed burst resistance. And finally, it comes with the driver Exceed. And Exceed is a really cool, interesting driver. It's, if you can imagine, it has the life after death of Destroy because it's a free spin driver, but it also has the attack power and speed of Quick Dash because it has a rubber flat in the middle. So that gives the Beyblade really good attack power. But then again, if it's versing like a left spin Beyblade and it goes down to life after death, it definitely has decent life after death because of its free spin part. And yeah, Super Hyperion is just a really solid attack type Beyblade. It hits like a wall. It throws Beyblades out of the stadium. I feel like if Super Hyperion were to verse, or if a Chozy version of Super Hyperion were to be made and verse Archer Hercules, I feel like it would totally obliterate Archer Hercules just because it has that much attack power. So yeah, that was the list of what I believe to be the best stock combo Beyblade from each series. If you guys want to see the best combo from each series, the best Beyblade combo from each Beyblade series, leave a like on this video. If this video gets, I don't know, like 5,000 likes, I'll do that in the future. So yeah, remember to rate, comment, and subscribe. And again, if you guys want to see more discussion videos, tell me in the comment section below that you enjoy them, or tell me in the comment section below to go back to battles. And yeah, see you guys later. Have a nice day. Left First out.